Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to share with you some interesting information about the Cygnus constellation. But before diving into it, I would like to share with you that our galaxy, the Milky Way, is in reality is a living being. It's a soul. It has a soul, a very complex soul, because you can imagine it can host many different kind of beings within it. So it's a very complex soul, but it's a living being for itself. So it's something that it's important to know, because it means that as a living being, it evolves, it expands consciousness, as all of us. It also receives information through the different beings that are part of it. So I mean with that planets, stars, nebula, and also many different kind of living beings, humans, non-humans, vegetables, animals of any kind. So it receives all of the information of all souls that are part of the galaxy, and in this way it can open its own consciousness, experiencing the different situations that we live here, I mean in the galaxy, and evolve. And now it is ready to take a step further in its own evolution and increase or enter into a higher dimension. And with it, all of us, all of sentient beings that are part of this galaxy are taking a step further in our evolution and enter into new dimensions, not only densities, but dimensions for themselves. I mean, we are entering into new spaces of fabrics, space-time, to experience new potentials of ourselves. And in this way, we will be able from now on to expand more also our heart chakra, our hearts, and continue to evolve towards more peace, harmony, compassion, well-being, and in this way decrease more and more the warlike energies that until now had been encompassing this galaxy, among others, I know, but we are talking about this one. So after saying all of that, now we can dive into the Cygnus constellation. Why the Cygnus constellation? Because, at least for me, it's a very complex constellation. This constellation has not only stars and planets, but also different kind of nebulas. They have some different kind of X-ray sources. It has black holes also. And also it means that it's a crossroad, we can say, to other universes, parallel universes. So it's a, how can I express it? It's a very important part of this galaxy. And because of that, because of its complexity and the potential that it holds to wormholes, black holes, as I said, it was attacked many, many billions of years ago by the Siacar, the reptilians, by the reptilians mainly, that at that moment were allied with few insectoid, with few gray races. And they attacked this region of the galaxy. And the war at that moment was really fierce, violent. Many, many different planets explode and disappear. One of them was the Earth. What I mean about that? I mean that the Earth as a planet in the 3D, began there. She was at that moment a planet orbiting the star Deneb, the main star, that also is very, very far away from us, around 2,000 and 7,000 light years, imagine. So at that moment she was orbiting the star Deneb, and as a consequence of the violent wars, the planet explode, and the soul of the planet, at the moment wasn't Earth, but it was the same soul, the soul of the planet was thrown off violently, the planet, and wandered in the universe without knowing what happened in reality to her, to her physical body, until some Syrian beings that now are part of the higher council of the Syrian stellar system, some of the Syrian beings took her, rescued her, and took her to Sirius system. They managed to help her to heal the scars, the trauma of being thrown off suddenly her own body. And then once she was prepared to become one more time as a planet, she came here and became what now we know as Earth. But there's more, because in the Cygnus constellation, there are many different kind of beings. At that moment, before the Cygnus Wars, the constellation was teeming with many, many different kinds of life, humanoids and non-humanoids. And after the wars, only few remain. Accordingly to Elena Danan, one of the races that remain, or that is that comes from the Cygnus constellation, is the Solipsi Rai. What I remember, I can say what I remember about them is that they at the beginning were humanoids, or humans, we can say, that because of the wars, the Cygnus wars, their DNA degrade their consciousness collapse, we can say, in some way, until they became grace. But at the beginning, they were a peaceful human race until they were involved in the Cygnus Wars that took place before the Lyran Wars. So they have, for example, accordingly to Elena Danan, they have a powerful weapon that keeps at bay the hostile alien races, but so some of them lived there, but others allied with the Orion Empire and the Reptilian Empire, the Siakar Empire. And even they have worked here on Earth together with the US government in exchange for humans. So they were responsible for part of the abductions, of the human abductions. Even they have been cloned and engineered to produce more of them as workers, slave workers, of course, by the Orion Empire and the Siakar Empire, and are classified this part, this cloned part of them, are classified as synthetic life forms. But as I said, in the Cygnus constellation live many, many different life forms, humans and non-humans. For example, the cows came from there. And there's also, for example, a humanoid race. They named themselves Concept, and they live on a planet orbiting the star Kepler-22. They are very tall, around 2.5-3 meters tall. They are very slim, with an elongated, very elongated face, pink skin, with many wrinkles along all their bodies, and they are the successors of a human or humanoid race that lived at that moment during the Cygnus Wars, and that was almost extinguished by the wars. But they are a race of priests and priestesses. They are telepathic and vocal. Males wear long white robes with a golden decorative band here around their collars, while the females also wear long robes, but without a collar, because it is a reminiscence of their past male-oriented society at that moment during the wars. They were male-oriented. They were also very technological at that moment, until during the wars, as they were almost extinguished, they realized that the technology was a double-edged sword, and because of that, they retreat. They retreat to the inner planet, to their inner planet. So they retreat from the wars that were taking place. Their planet almost was barren, with very little life left because of the wars. It was really barren, I saw and perceived it, almost deserted. with few remaining mountains and valleys, but almost all deserted. So they retreat to the inner planet, and then they made a decision to continue to evolve, but only focusing to expand their own consciousness from their hearts, also to expand their consciousness and be more aligned with the cosmic mind that represents this galaxy, but they refuse to use the technology. So since then, they have thrown off all kind of technology, because at that moment the trauma was really deep, and they prefer to evolve only from their own consciousness, focus to expand their own consciousness. Because of that, they are not a space-faring civilization, but as they manage to terraform their planet, and as they expanded more and more their consciousness, and they realize that in reality, technology is only a projection of the potential of our consciousness. So it's not necessary to be focused on build technology for whatever reason, but at the contrary, only focusing our intention to expand our consciousness, our knowledge, our understanding of ourselves and all living beings, we can evolve until a point that we can develop technology, but accordingly to our consciousness. I mean with that, for example, they have developed some kind of fabric that is imbued with consciousness, with their own consciousness. So the person that wears the fabric imbued it with his or her own consciousness. So the fabric is like a second skin that protects the person from the weather, hot, cold, but also it can be some shield to protect them from weapons. And what else? Ah, yes. And this kind of fabric help them to to blend with their own surroundings, so they can be unseen, they can be cognizable. So you cannot see them with your own eyes because they are blend with the environment. And also, what else? For example, they have some kind of staff that in reality is a weapon, but is an interdimensional weapon. It means that if they are if some invaders, some enemies, we can say, come to their own planet, they can shoot them with this stuff. They can shoot them, and the energy that comes out of the stuff is an interdimensional energy. So it means that it throws off the invader, the non-wanted being, and also stun it. So this kind of energy not only throws away the enemy, but even returns it, or him, mm-hmm. her, returns it to its own world. And also, it makes it stand at least for some time. And is a way that they developed with their own consciousness as a way to not kill anybody, but keep everybody at bay. What else? For example, they were able to develop some hologram, we can say, hologram that surrounds their planet. And the hologram shows the barren planet that became during the Cygnus Wars. But in reality, if you go through the hologram, below it, there's the real planet with lakes, rivers, vegetation, trees, plants, because they terraformed it and they were successful. So and their message for us is that the technology is only a dense replicator of the capabilities of our own consciousness. We don't need it, but expand our consciousness accordingly to the potential that the cosmic mind offers us, and always be embedded or being held by love or sustained by love. It means that for us as humans here on Earth, they don't mean that throw away all your technology, not all your devices. No, it's not this, the message. But use the devices, be a smartphone, smart TV, even a car. Okay? Use them for the highest good of you and all. And in this way, don't use it only for the power, for power, for being, for greed, for example, but only use them for the highest good of all. So it's beautiful, the message, and also it's something that, well, it's, I agree, because deep inside me, I always said to my friends, for example, or people that like to listen to me in a more personal way, that that devices are not necessary, because all that the devices show us or can do, in reality, we can do the same and more using our consciousness. Although, of course, at this moment of the development of the humanity, it would mean that is the creation, the construction of new device, conscious devices would be very slow, because first we need to go within, we need to develop more telepathy and other extrasensory potentials, I can say, but in reality, all that a device can do, our consciousness can. Also, for example, in the same planet, there's another species. They are the Murubut. The Murubut are worm species. They are telepathic, and they are devoted also to expand their consciousness, because they are worms doesn't mean that they don't have consciousness or they only have a very primitive consciousness. They are devoted, as I said, to expand and evolve their consciousness as a way to help other worm species across the galaxy to evolve. Their bodies are around 1.5 meters long. They have two lines of legs as a centipede here on Earth, with 22 legs each line. And they are burrowers, of course, and also helped the humanoid, to reconstruct and terraform their planet. So they work together. And about the Cygnus constellation today, that's it. Well, only one thing. Our sun is conjunct with the different stars of the Cygnus constellation during the month of Aquarius and Pisces. So, although now, as I record this video, is almost summer, but I like to share with you my own experiences with different kind of Cygnus beings. And because of that, I share also my own experience about the history of the Earth and part of the history of the galaxy. So for today, that's it. Have a wonderful day with love and light.